This video is a demonstration of how to configure your Sensortech NIR Series Analyzer for product calibration and its associated constituents. For this demonstration, we will be configuring a dual constituent NIR-6001 Analyzer to measure coating and moisture. Additionally, we will be setting calibration codes for three levels of coating thickness. Firstly, connect your NIR Analyzer to a PC or laptop with Sensortech's configuration software preloaded and start the application. Once the configuration software is running, go ahead and select the Find Network Gauges button. You will see a list of connected analyzers in the list box to the right of the Find Network Gauges button, and in this case you will see Default ID listed. Double-click Default ID in the list box and it will be displayed in the Select Gauge field. Select the red Connect button and it will turn green and display it as connected. You will see the fields to the right filled in, and this will indicate that the analyzer is connected to the application. Next, you will want to log in using your engineering password. Enter the password in the field to the left of the red login button and select the button to log in. If successful, you will see the red login button turn green and display the text log out. Once logged in, you will see the configuration and calibration tabs appear towards the top of the application. Go ahead and select the configuration tab and navigate to the product code configuration submenu. From here you will see the General Parameters tab and notice a drop-down menu that displays three constituents and a temperature option. This analyzer is configured for two constituents and does not include the temperature measurement option. Selecting between constituent 1 and constituent 2 will change between the factory settings for each of the constituents. You can edit the constituent names in the Constituent Names tab by changing the text and selecting the Send button. Note that these names are generally set at the factory and you will receive the analyzer with the names already in place, although we do give you the option to change these names if desired. You will notice that the constituent names will be changed and this will be reflected in the constituent drop-down menu back in the General Parameters tab. The factory set R1 ratio is set for each constituent and you will see the change when changing between coating and moisture. Setting product or calibration codes are a simple task and you may do this in the Product Specific Parameters tab located next to the General Parameters tab. You should note that every NIR Series Analyzer is equipped with 50 product codes and you can set these from the product drop-down menu. For this example, we will set three product calibration codes, light, medium, and heavy coating. We will call the first product code light coating and enter this in the product name field. Select the Send button and the product code is sent. Now we will set the product code 2 as medium coating and product code 3 as heavy coating. Coefficient B and C are the calibration coefficients for each of the product codes. For our purpose of demonstration, we will change coefficient C for each of the product/calibration codes so that we can see the difference when we switch between the different product calibration codes. Note that you must send all changes before selecting a different product code. Calibrating each of the product or calibration codes, both B and C coefficients, are done from the Calibration tab, but this is out of the scope of this demonstration. Calibration is a simple process and the relationship between the analyzer's measurement and the constituent being measured is linear. Thus, the calibration is essentially the equation of a line, with coefficient B being the slope and coefficient C being the y-intercept. We can see that we have set calibrations for low, medium, and high coating and have changed the C coefficient for each of the calibrations so we can see how the different calibrations affect the measurement. Placing a sample in the measurement path of the analyzer, we will be measuring a static target with only the calibrations changing between the product or calibration codes. Moving to the main tab of the application, we will select the red start button to begin pulling data. You can see that the product select drop-down menu is set for light coating and the measurement values are indicated in real time in the upper right hand corner. Selecting product or calibration code medium coating in the drop-down menu stops pulling, but we will resume by reselecting the red start button. The measurement registers off the chart, so we will scale the y-axis max to include all measurement of both light and medium coating. Here you will see the step change in the coating measurement as we change the C coefficient for medium coating to increase the y-intercept. Notice that the moisture measurement does not change as we did not change the B or C coefficients for the moisture constituent. The heavy coating again changes the measurement as the C coefficient again increases the y-intercept equation of the line. Notice the moisture measurement has still not changed. We will change the scale of the chart so you can see the change once again. Moving back to the product-specific parameters, we will change the moisture calibration to demonstrate the ability to calibrate the moisture constituent by selecting the Constituent drop-down menu. Changing the Constituent drop-down menu to Moisture will allow you to set the calibration for moisture in the light coating product or calibration code. Selecting Medium Coating will allow you to change the moisture calibration for that product or calibration code. Again, we do the same for the heavy coating product or calibration code. Switching back to the main tab, we will resume polling data, starting with the light coating product or calibration tab, and you will notice a change in the moisture measurement as we had changed the seal coefficient or y-intercept of the moisture calibration. Again, we switch to medium coating and see the moisture measurement change as we would expect. Finally, we do the same for heavy coating and see the measurement change for a third time. Again, we must change the scale of the graph to include the final heavy coating measurement. We have demonstrated how to set different product and calibration codes and each constituent. In this case, we have set the coating and moisture constituent for three different calibrations: light, medium, and heavy coating. Sensortech's configuration software has many features and is easy to operate and highly intuitive. With little time, you can master the operation of your NIR series analyzer. If you have any questions, feel free to contact Sensortech Systems Incorporated.